Will everyone please return to your seats?
There are precedents aplenty for both sides of this issue. In re Karen Ann Quinlan, the Supreme Court of New Jersey recognized the preservation of a personal right to privacy against bodily intrusions. In Belchertown versus Salkowitz, the court held that the right to refuse medical treatment in appropriate circumstances extends to both competent and incompetent persons. And the law holds that a deliberate decision to embark on an action which will eventually lead to death is not ipso facto evidence of insanity. If it were, society would have to condemn many men to dishonorable burial rather than posthumous medals. Yet, we do have to remember Mr. Harrison's mind is affected, and we must in this case be most careful not to allow Mr. Harrison's intelligence to blind us to the fact that he may be suffering from a depressive illness, which would diminish his ability to make an informed decision. We must ignore Mr. Harrison's cogently argued plea to be allowed to die if we believe it to be the product of a disturbed or clinically depressed mind. However, I am satisfied that Mr. Harrison is a brave and thoughtful man who is in complete possession of his mental faculties, and I therefore order that he be set free. That's it, gentlemen. Peggy, you want to get that? You got your hanging, Judge.
I think not. Thank you. Thank you very much, Your Honor.
I hope so.
Somewhere, I suppose.
There's no need for that.
Don't start it again.
You can stay here. We'll stop all treatment, no dialysis. We can stop feeding if you like. You'll be in a coma in a few days, dead in a week, two at most. But you won't be alone. There'll be very little discomfort.
No last-minute attempt at resuscitation?
Only if you ask for it.
Thank you. It would obviously be easier for me if I stayed.
Okay, I'll take care of that.
Why are you doing this?
Because you might change your mind.